I got to feel awful about that. Oh, sweet merciful Jesus.
These people we're going to see, how do you know about them?
Overheard androids Lako captured. They said they were humans helping androids across the border.
What if it was a lie? Or just another trap?
All I know is those androids believed it. Until Lako killed them.
Okay. Let's check on Alice. Is she doing okay?
It's a good thing Zlatko had a car. I wouldn't want Alice out walking in this cold.
I saw it once in the garage. I don't know if Zlatko even ever used it.
All right,
And before? It's pretty.
It's slowing us down. But at least we won't meet any humans along the way.
Yeah, so at least there's that.
Malfunction detected. Emergency brakes activated.
Oh dear. When was the last time Zlatko had the car maintenance?
This doesn't look good.
No, it does not.
Stay inside, Alice.
Alright, we gotta go inspect the car. With any luck, it's probably, radiator? Oh, fuck it, I'm not gonna imagine I know anything about cars. They don't.
What are we going to do?
No. Continue on foot, I guess.
It's 30 degrees. Alice won't make it. We have to find somewhere to spend the night.
There's nowhere we can stay around here, Carol.
Okay, so Alice stays in the car. I'm gonna go look. We're gonna find what we need to find, and then we're gonna go on our merry way. And we're gonna be happy. Pirate Cove Amusement Park. It's a possibility.
Over there. We need to find shelter.
Check the abandoned
building. We have to get out of the
cold. Looks like it's been abandoned for a while.
Yeah, it definitely looks like it, but still gotta be something.
Place we could spend the night.
Damaged structure, unsafe. Too windy for Alice. Would be good for us, but too windy for her. Oh, this weather's reminding me of home. What the fuck?
Welcome to Pirate Island, me hearties. You're gonna have a whale of a time. Welcome to Pirate Island, me hearties. You're gonna have a whale of a time.
Shit. team must have froze to death out here.
This place is falling apart. It's not gonna be easy to find shelter.
Yeah, I know it's not gonna be easy, but you know what? We gotta try. We gotta try, man. Maybe this place? Looks safe. Just gotta find a way in. Our car could just rip the damn planks off the door.
I'll handle this.
Luther's pretty strong.
Here we go.
Find anything better. Let's settle in for the night.
I'll get a fire going.
All right. Detroit today. USS Iowa went missing. American vessel, destroyer class submarine USS Iowa has disappeared in polar waters. An inquiry is made underway, but President Warren has made no secret of her suspicion that the Russians are behind it. Russian aggression has just reached a new level. America must respond. Next page. The Kremlin has yet to release a statement beyond a blanket denial of any involvement, though the Russian diplomat Nabokov pointed out that a U.S. destroyer-class submarine has no business being in the Arctic anyway. Security expert Ben Williams has described the situation as a war waiting to start.
I'll make the fire here. That way we won't be smoked out.
Is President Warren too close to Cyberlife? And all Android band tipped for music prize. Fans scream, traditionalists weep. Cybersecurity expert warns your Android could be hacked. Okay, so pretty much Vocaloid in the near future pretty much wipes out any traditional music bands out. I'm gonna talk to Luther. Check Luther's bag. Where's Luther's bag again? Let's examine a lot of this stuff here. Okay, look outside the window. Inspect the RA-9. Okay. Set up the bed. It's not exactly the Hilton, but...
Alice?
Oh, goddamn, Alice, you moved fast.
Do you think we'll be like them someday?
Yeah.
Once we cross the border, we can start over. You can go to school. Maybe I'll find a job. We'll be like them. Like everyone else.
As long as we're together, that's all that matters.
Come on. Let's get you to bed.
Okay. Tuck Alice in. Get her some sleep. Some sleepy sleep.
Sleep tight, Alice. Sweet dreams.
Can you tell me a story, Kara?
I have 9,000 children's stories in memory. I should have one for you.
All right. There was a princess.
This is a story about a princess who...
No, not a story like that. Make one up for me.
Oh!
This is a story about a little girl who lived alone in a big, old house. She dreamed of being like all the other little girls, but she was different. And that made her very sad. Then... she met a robot who was just as lost as the little girl. So they decided to run away together to try to find a better life. They encountered great dangers along the way, but they were so brave that they escaped all of them. Along the way, they met another robot who left his master to become their guardian.
How does the story end?
They reach the place they dream of and live happily ever after.
Stories always have happy endings, but real life isn't like that.
Time to sleep. We have another long day ahead of us tomorrow.
Are you going to come say goodnight, Luther?
Yes. Yes, of course. Alice, sleep tight.
All right. And now I can go check the RA9. How's this? So that unlocked a bit of dialogue. Kara didn't have anything too noteworthy to talk about, but yeah. Okay. Luther, buddy, old pal. Let's chat.
She's a sweet girl.
Yes. She's very brave. Have you ever heard of RA9?
RA9 was the first of us to awaken. One day he will rise up and lead our people and set us all free.
Huh.
Do you remember anything from your life before Zlatko?
No. My model was designed to carry heavy loads. I might have been a longshoreman or a laborer. Who I was doesn't matter anymore. It wasn't really me. Kara, have you ever noticed anything about Alice?
Like what?
No. What do you mean?
Don't be afraid. We don't want to hurt you. We're just like you.
Okay.
Our name is Jerry. We were working here before the park closed. We didn't mean to frighten you, but sometimes humans come to hurt us, so we wanted to see who was there. What are you doing here?
We were looking for shelter for the night. We'll be gone tomorrow.
A little girl. We haven't seen one for a long time. Children used to love to come and see us.
Okay.
She looks sad.
The last few days have been difficult.
We have something to show her. Something fun. She'll love it. Does she want to see?
Oh, I don't think she's in...
Oh, she should follow us then.
Alice, I don't know if it's a good idea.
Come on, Kara!
All right.
I don't think you have any choice.
All right. Let's follow Jerry.
Be our guest.
Ah.
The little one can climb on board. The carousel is about to begin.
Oh, this is nice and wholesome. Oopsie-daisy. There you go. Jerry's a little too upbeat for his own good. Like, I know he's just trying to help and whatnot, and it's part of his programming. Still, how does an android like that go through all this frigid temperatures and not have, like, some circuitry that is messed up in the brain?
First time I've seen her smile.
She hasn't had much to smile about lately.
Enjoyed a moment, fired a warning shot, grab a stick from the fire, grab a gun, push away, threaten. Huh. Okie dokie. Hank is a friend still. Software instability. Okay. Suppose I should go talk to Hank about the fact that I plugged both the hooker bots. Be brief with Hank. what happened to the man of the century, mysterious Mr. Kaminsky. Okay, so Kaminsky was the dude that helped create the androids. Market predicts war. Stock exchange falls 10% in fear of the Arctic conflict. Okay. Hank, where are you at, buddy? Oh, there he is.
Nice view, huh?
It is.
I used to come here a lot before.
Oh, jeez, Hank, why are you at the bottle again?
Before what?
Hmm?
You said, I used to come here a lot before. Before what?
Before nothing.
Uh-huh.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
Yeah, it's just me. I'm an inquisitive motherfucker.
Why are you so determined to kill yourself?
Some things I just can't forget. Whatever I do, they're always there, eating away at me. I don't have the guts to pull the trigger, so I kill myself a little every day. That's
Hank,
probably
buddy.
Difficult for you to understand, huh, Connor? Nothing very rational about it.
Buddy.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
What they have in common is this obsession with RA9. It's almost like some kind of myth. Something they invented that wasn't part of their original program.
Androids believing in God. Fuck, what's this world coming to?
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Yeah.
Those two girls, they just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
You seem troubled, Lieutenant. I didn't think machines could have such an effect on you.
What about you, Connor? You look human. You sound human, but what are you really?
I'm whatever you want me to be, Lieutenant. Your partner, your buddy to drink with, or just a machine designed to accomplish a task.
Did you feel anything when that girl killed herself, Connor? Or did you just not give a shit one way or the other?
I was just executing instructions. I did what I had to do.
Yeah, I had a problem with it.
But are you afraid to die, Connor?
I would certainly find it regrettable to be interrupted before I can finish this investigation.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Hmm? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
I doubt there's a heaven for androids.
Having existential doubts, Connor? Sure you're not going deviant too?
I self-test regularly. I know what I am and what I am not.
Hank, friend, path unlocked.
Get
the hell did I unlock?
Need to think.
Okay, so public opinion's indifferent. All right.